Gourds start out green like this one, which I made a flower vase out of. They are 80% water. This water needs to evaporate out of the gourd, which takes several months. In the process of a gourd drying out, the skin of the gourd begins to get wet and moldy, like this one. But this is all part of the drying process. Now this one here is almost done drying. You can see the skin is mostly dry and peeling off. However, the bottom is still wet and it is still on the heavier side, so this one needs some more time for drying. Now this one here is completely dry. The skin is dry all around the gourd. It is light, and with most gourds you can hear the seeds rattling inside when you shake it. I will show you how to give a dried gourd a good cleaning. You will need a bucket or tub. I'm using a 5-gallon bucket and will be soaking 3 gourds at once. I often use a plastic tub for larger batches. A metal scouring pad. You can also use a plastic scrubber or a Brillo pad. A large absorbent rag. I'm using an old bath towel. Weights. I use dumbbells in this video, although I have used bricks, rocks, paver stones, and cinder blocks. Whatever works for you. Rubber gloves. I have 1 pair and I use it for everything, from cleaning gourds to dyeing them and varnishing them. Plastic apron. Rack for drying. Some place away from animals with plenty of air circulation. Hanging them up will work too. Fill a bucket with warm water. You may add liquid soap if you like. Soak the towel with water. Set aside. Put dirty gourds in the water. Put the wet towel over the gourds. Then weight it down with your weight. Wait several hours. I normally start soaking gourds in the morning and clean them in the evening or vice versa. First, put on rubber gloves and apron. Remove weight and towel. Since I was soaking 3 gourds, I set 2 aside to work on later. Take your metal scouring pad and begin scrubbing. Keep scrubbing till all the dirt, mold, and skin is off. This takes some elbow grease, but the soaking helps a lot and I often find it pretty easy. But there are times when the gourd can be pretty stubborn, and you may want to have a butter knife on hand to scrape the more stubborn skin off. Don't forget to clean the stem. Once the gourd is clean, let it dry for a day or so on the rack. It's best to make sure the gourd is dry inside and out before you begin crafting. If the gourd is not real thick, you may crack or puncture the gourd in a spot where it got soggy from the soaking. For my next video, I'll show you how to clean the interior of a gourd. Happy gourding!